My name is Stuart Oglesby, and I'm a practicing general dentist in Williamsburg, Virginia. I have a practice that covers a broad spectrum of services, but one of my passions is the treatment of TMD, which is temporomandibular dysfunction, popularly known as TMJ by the general public. TMD is a result of numerous things, but really the prime etiology that is overlooked by pediatricians, pediatric dentists, and the medical community as a whole is airway restriction in children during growth and development, leading to mouth breathing. Now, mouth breathing sounds innocent enough. We have to breathe to live. However, when you breathe through your mouth instead of your nose, it sets up a cascade of events which can be catastrophic leading into adulthood. Such events would be constriction of the jaws, making your teeth very crowded, leading to orthodontics. Others would be grinding and clenching of teeth. One other result is something that we dentists don't always think about, but the fact the mouth's connected to the rest of the body. And therefore, when you become a mouth breather, the body will maximize that and cause you to forward head posture, meaning your head will not be centered over your neck. This forward head posturing is to pull the tongue away from the back of the throat, because when you jut your head forward, the lower jaw comes forward and the tongue is attached to the front of the lower jaw, and it will pull the tongue away from the soft palate, which is where most obstructions of airway occur. In this practice, we treat children and adults, children in a preventive sort of way, by identifying allergies that could lead to airway restriction and early interventive orthodontics with phase one expansion and bite opening. Rarely do we do what's known as extraction retraction orthodontics, where adult teeth are removed and therefore you condemn your child to a constricted arch by closing those spaces where those adult teeth were removed. In this particular case, I'm presenting Julie Baker, who is my hygienist, and she's an example of 8 out of 10 people in the population who have bad bites. Now, Julie has had orthodontics in the past. She did not have adult teeth extracted, but she had orthodontics done in a way that straightened her teeth, but did not straighten her bite. Now, what we had discovered by doing a proper and thorough test and diagnostic procedure with Julie is that her skeletal bite and dental bite is overclosed. Not just a little bit overclosed, but 16 millimeters overclosed, which in dental terms is way overclosed. So she has a deep bite. What that has led to is a jamming of her jaw joint into the socket right in front of the ears. Now, what this symptomology may present as is ringing in the ears, headaches, dizziness, certainly grinding and clenching of the teeth, breakage of teeth, root canals, failed root canals, and of course, head and neck and shoulder pain and discomfort. I will let Julie tell you in her own words, her own testimony, as we begin her treatment, which will be multi-phase and involve orthodontics as well as possibly full mouth reconstruction in the future to reestablish this overclosure that is so severe that it has debilitated her to the point of compromising her ability to work. Julie's 29 years old, just beginning her career as a hygienist, being a hygienist for 4 or 5 years, and has already suffered numbing and tingling in the arms and hands, and of course the associated neck issues that you might expect with forward head posturing and the other things that I discussed. So here's Julie.
All right, I am Julie. I am a hygienist at Dr. Oglesby's office. I have suffered from TMJ discomfort from 2006 after I got out of braces. I had daily headaches, chronic neck pain that I was seeing chiropractor for. I'm currently in a jaw repositioner bite corrector from Dr. Oglesby that I have worn since April, and I have only had 4 headaches in 6 months. From this point, I will go into braces to permanently correct my bite and possibly some limited reconstruction, different crowns in different areas to help permanently stabilize my bite and permanently relieve my headaches.
So what I've done up to this point is I've hooked Julie up to the TENS machine, which is, if you look very closely, you can see her muscles of facial expression are contracting, and also when you stick your finger between her teeth, you can feel her chewing muscles are contracting. And this is the relaxation phase of neuromuscular dentistry using pulse low frequency TENS. Now, we're going to record her relaxed position and jaw movement by placing this magnet right in her mouth against her teeth and gums. Now, what else we have on her are the EMG electrodes that will pick up the muscular readings. And what we have going on here is the scan array, and the scan array will pick up the movement of her jaw. So we have myotrobes picking up the muscle activity, and we have the scan array picking up the jaw movement. We're actually getting ready to measure her bite. Of course, Julie already has her bite corrector in, so we're just going to check to see how that's doing. And but these are her actual muscles being read by the computer here as they fluctuate. And then you can see these, what we call cylinders down here, and those are recording how relaxed her muscles are. We like to see a lot of white space between them, and so some of them are relaxed and others are less so. But not bad, really, overall. So I'm going to direct Julie right now. Julie, bite, tap, tap, and that's great. Since she has her orthotic in, I'm not having her go through any other directions, and that's basically it. And here's her reading, and down here is her relaxed bite, and you can even see some looping here, which is an indication of poor posture, which is affecting her bite. And normally we do relax the shoulder muscles. For this demonstration, we didn't. And this just shows that she can stand to be opened even further than we have her with her orthotic. But she's almost completely on trajectory, about a millimeter, 0.9 tenths of a millimeter, a little retruded wearing her orthotic. So we'll be working on that in the future to alleviate that. But she can stand to be opened even further than the correction I have right now. And this is using science to correct bites rather than guesswork or the lab. It takes the guesswork out of figuring out how to correct someone's bite. And bite correction is essential when you're treating TMD. What you've seen is the advanced equipment and computer technology that hasn't left dentistry behind and is used to diagnose but also to treat Julie. This falls under the general term of neuromuscular dentistry, and it finally takes the profession of dentistry out of the realm of being tooth mechanics to being mouth doctors that dovetails nicely with the rest of the medical community. If you would like to learn more about neuromuscular dentistry, it's a term that's found readily on the internet, or you can certainly find out more information on my website, WilliamsburgCosmeticDentistry.com.